been for you?
Just playing basketball at the end of the day. That's what it is. So new role, new timing, all of that. So once I get out there, it's just basketball.
Tilo, obviously the fourth time seeing Phoenix, but the first time with their big three fully healthy. I think they accounted for 67% of their points. What did you see from them at the beginning that made it challenging once they were able to get going?
They got the scoring, and it was kind of tough for us to kind of slow it down a little bit. Fouls and turnovers on top of that kind of just made it an easier night for them. So, tough team.
Yeah. D'Lo, a couple for you. We haven't spoken to you since the tailbone injury. Physically, are you back to 100%? You had, I think, a knee thing tonight. Are you physically
good? Yeah, I'm good.
And secondly, the reality of this league is that people talk about trades and stuff like that. Like, this is that time of year. How do you personally handle that discussion about yourself and your status? I know last year you spoke about being comfortable. Yeah. I guess, are you uncomfortable right now?
Me? No.
Yeah, as these things kind of rattle around?
No, I mean, it is what it is. Since I've been in the league, I've kind of been dealing with that to where I know I can't control it. I know those things happen no matter how well or how well you play, how professional you act, how many shots you make or miss, it's gonna happen regardless. So I don't really go about my day and worry about that, to be honest.
I watched the first episode of your podcast yesterday.
My podcast? What's the name of it?
Backyard.
Yeah. Backyard.
The Backyard.
Heck yeah, yep.
And you talked about a conversation you had with Dwayne Wade on a trip to China.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, you know, it's a guy who played alongside LeBron a lot and had a lot of success. You mentioned something about him telling you ways to find energy. I'm just wondering if you could elaborate on that story.
I mean, it was just kind of, but I went to China kind of right after the season. So it was just along the lines of, you know, the playoffs were still fresh, Western Conference, all of that. And I didn't go out the way I wanted to go out. I didn't perform the way I wanted to perform, things like that. And I ended up going to China, and D-Wade was there, and he just mentioned that, you know, the whole bullet train was only probably 4 or 5 hours, and it was just all basketball, high-level basketball conversation, you know, ways to play alongside LeBron, you know, things like that, ways to affect the game without the ball, you know, things like that. So being here now is just a newer position than I've ever been in. Now and when I first got here, last season. So just continuing to weather the storm, weather the adjustments, and try to stay positive through the adversity.
Angelo, you guys have had, you know, some pockets of really effective offense, certainly in-season tournament, games here or there, but it hasn't been consistent as a team. I'm just wondering what are some of the things you're seeing on that end that are working well, some that aren't as much, and as you know, approach this next stretch of games.
I don't know. it's a lot we could, you know, talk about right now. As far as what could we fix, I don't know, short term, figure it out and try to be better next game. I don't know. I think it's just a lot of holes in our system right now that we're, you use the regular season to figure those things out. With the ups and downs, the digression, the setbacks, all these things, injuries, just keep playing a part in our success. So just next guy mentality, I think, having a positive energy coming into work, you know, practice and things like that, and getting better from game to game. I think that's where we start. We look at this game and get better in ways that we may have haven't had to look at, you know, throughout the season. Right now is the time to figure it out and do something about it, whatever that may be.
When you're trying to figure out ways to plug those holes, are you finding that it's the same things that are coming up more often than not? Within the team, or do you feel like there are new sets of problems, like the challenges of today weren't the challenges of 3 weeks
ago? Yeah, there's so many different, you know, challenges that, you know, we got to try to bottle them up and limit as many as we can, you know, just to try to scrape out some wins, you know. I think we're a team that's still figuring things out. We're still mixing and matching lineups, you know, finishing groups, starting groups. Like, we're still figuring it out. So I wouldn't say panic, you know, or anything like that. I'm sure last year, the prime example of this team not being where they wanted to be, and we had some new energy, new vibes, and it kind of made, it got us to where we ended off last year. So I think, you know, you can still see light at the end of the tunnel, but we just got to get better, got to keep getting better.
Thanks, Devo. Yep.
A couple of games with extended minutes against the Lakers earlier in the season, played well, and obviously they noticed. Just wondered what the conversations were like after getting away from Portland and just the process by which you're here.
I mean, it was a quick turnaround, so I'm just still trying to figure names out and get my feet wet. But, you know, I just always, every time I get a chance to play, I just try to come in, play with confidence and play the right way. And, you know, I'm super thankful to be here. It's an honor to be here. It's still pinching myself a little bit, but, you know, I'm excited to come in and learn and get better and see what's going on here.
You got to see some parts of your game, like with the operating screen roll in that fourth quarter and, you know, using the bigs and things like that. Where do you feel like your skill set kind of most fits, and what's the early communication with the coaching staff about what they think you could focus on?
And, I work hard on everything. I'm obviously feel like I'm really strong in the pick and roll, but I've learned to play off the ball. I think I've grown as a cutter, a space guy, so... You know, I take pride in being versatile and trying to make plays on both ends of the court.
Hey, Skylar, first off, welcome.
Thank you.
So, what would you say your comfort level was out there tonight, you know, kind of getting into the rhythm and then also just playing, you know, in crypto for the Lakers?
Well, I love to play, and I think I know what I'm doing out there. So, I mean, regardless of what team I'm on, it's the same game. So, I felt comfortable playing. And I think I'll get better as I learn who I'm playing with and get more acclimated to the guys.
Hey, Skylar, I know it's just been a few days, but what's the biggest thing you've learned about this group, about this team, you know, do shoot-arounds or, you know, do a couple of games around them?
I think since we're an older team, that the pace is a lot faster as far as getting through sets and schemes. You know, you've got guys who've played in this league, you know, for long time, so you know we're getting through things quick, and I'm just trying to keep up.
Hey, Skylar, as a point guard, have you thought about potentially playing with LeBron and AD, and what that could do for your game?
Yeah, I mean, playing with players like that could only help me, both learning and you know getting time with them, and you know as far as learning, I mean watching. But you know, I'm excited to you know keep getting used to what's going on here and. Hoping for a chance to play with them.
Skylar, just wondering defensively, where do you kind of think your skill set is? Is it point of attack or the off ball, weak side? Or what are the points of emphasis for you on that side?
I like being on the ball. I think that's where I can just keep growing. But, you know, I think defense is a pride thing, a want-to thing. So, you know, I try to go out there and give max effort every time.
In the five-out offense, how do you think your play can help improve that part of the game?
Well, I think I'm a gifted passer. Like I said, I think I've gotten better as a cutter. So, you know, when this five-out offense, when everything is spaced out, you know, you just kind of drive gaps and be aggressive. And that's what I was kind of trying to tell Fino and Dylan and that younger group that was in at the end of the game.
Anything else? Thanks, Skylar.
Thank you. Anyone open? Like, just we turned the ball over. We had nine turnovers for their 17 points in the first half. I had to go back and look, but a bunch of them were live ball turnovers. And they made shots. This team had with a three-headed monster of guys is, you know, accustomed to making shots with a hand in their face. That's what they do. That's what they've done, those three individuals, their entire career. And so, you know, they made shots. I thought we were there at different times, forced them into some tough situations where they capitalized. But again, story of the game early, especially that set the tone for them. And, you know, really hampered us was the turnovers. You know, you just can't turn the ball over. You know, you play great defense. You got to give yourself a chance to go back and attack the opposing team. And when you turn the ball over, especially live ball turnovers, they're able to get runouts. Open threes, open looks, get their confidence going. It can make it difficult, but no, never, ever do we scheme to give up open shots.
Mike, do you have Mike, go ahead. Yep.
Darvin, from a individual defensive effort standpoint, do you feel like you're getting enough from everybody on a consistent basis?
I mean, it's tough, man. We got some guys dealing with some ailments. We got some guys under some minute restrictions. Obviously, C. Will was dealing with a migraine headache, something, you know, he has a history of. It was just a tough night, one of those nights. And we started out extremely flat, seemed to be running in mud there. A little loose with the ball. You know, I just mentioned the turnovers. It was tough, tough night. You know, felt like we were trying to make the right play. We stepped short, second too late. It's just one of those nights, man. It's a tough, tough night. You know, Cam started trying to push through, dealing with some issues with his left knee. He's getting looked at right now as we speak. So we had to pull him early. And again, not having C. Wood, obviously, Rui being out, it's just tough. You know, it's just we have to push through, stay together and push through. No one's going to feel sorry for us. It's like, just got to man up and hopefully get as healthy as we can and get on that plane tomorrow with focus to go get a game in Utah.
After the Clipper win, so much of that was about defensive intensity.
Yes.
And do you think that with the way this team is, that that can be a night? Like, I mean, in the two games since, right, Toronto scores 130-plus points, Phoenix tonight gets going. Like, is it disappointing that, I mean, after you guys get sort of like that kind of win against yeah. Clippers, that there hasn't been carryover? And does that concern you at all about the ability of this team to play like it did against the Clippers on a night-to-night basis in the regular season?
As I mentioned, there's different circumstances that play into that inconsistency. You know, we just have to figure it out. I don't want to sit up here and try to make excuses. But, yeah, you want to feel like you can go out there every single night and give yourself a chance with the way you defend and the way you guard. You know, guys in this league, you know, their skill level, you know, it's very few nights off. Their skill level's through the roof, and then, you know, you'll see something similar to the Clippers tonight, whereas they're not as methodical. They play with a lot more speed. When you talk about KD, Book, and Brad. And so one thing you have to do is give yourself every chance to be able to stop them. And when you're turning the ball over, there's this, you know, it's really difficult to stop anyone when you're giving away possessions like that.
Darvin, you mentioned the Cam injury. I went to Jared Vanderbilt. It seems like he's getting back to himself physically. What have you seen from him recently and kind of in context with him starting last year and then starting the season injured and coming back? Where do you think he's at right now?
I mean, I just think he's starting to see that burst again. You know, him chasing down some 50-50 balls, him getting some offensive rebounds, and just his activity has increased with each and every game. Knows where to be. He can make a play with the ball in his hands for a teammate. But just that burst of speed, that athleticism, that versatility, you're starting to see that quick twitch coming back.
And then you've spoken before about there being, you know, no garbage time minutes. You're always looking for something. Mays gets in there, gets some run in, when they're just wondered your impressions of them in their first stints.
Solid young pro. You know, that's why we brought him into the fold, as well as Dylan. Those young guys came in. D'Lo did a great job starting the fourth quarter, keeping us organized under some tough circumstances. And they continue to play hard, continue to play fast. Just have some things that didn't go our way tonight. You know, again, the story of the game really early and at different segments is turnovers.
I recognize, I'm sure you've probably been focused on yourself and the opponent directly in front of you, but the Utah Jazz have been one of the hotter teams in the NBA as of late. I don't know if you've addressed this yet, but if you haven't, what's the message going into that game at Tully?
Man, stay together, try to get as healthy as we possibly can as we prepare to get on that plane tomorrow. Fill your cups back up, and once we are healthy, focus on ball security. Being together, ball security, and let's try to get one up there. Whenever we're able to take care of ball, I mean, we've won games where we've had a bunch of turnovers, so you just, you know, you don't want them. You don't want to just help the other team. You know, you put your defense at risk when you're throwing the ball everywhere. You're not giving yourself every opportunity to go get a bucket or to put the opposing team on their heels. So once we get healthy and we get bodies back, we'll see how Rudy feels tomorrow. We'll see how C. Wood feels tomorrow. See what's going on with Cam. That's a lot to be out of your lineup. So hopefully, you know, get those guys back trending in the right direction for Saturday. Again, fill our cups back up and watch a little film on us. Watch a little film on them. Go through our process and get ready to tip it off and hopefully get a double.
Coach, with a night like this, Max Christie showed the type of toughness and intensity that you come to look for. Can you just talk to me about his game and his development?
Well, he's trying, man. You know, he's a young player, second year in the league. He's had some big minutes for us thus far. And, you know, you're going to have some plays that didn't go his way. He's still learning, you know, tendencies and trying to read different reads within the game, offensively, defensively. And we just want him to keep pushing, keep competing, keep playing hard. But he'll be someone that'll be in the thick of things for us for years to come.
Awesome.
LeBron didn't play all that much, had season low in points. Is there anything wrong with him physically or anything? Or is just, what was the thinking on how he's out there?
I mean, just shutting him down. The game had gotten out of hand. And so, you know, just trying to get a head start on what we're facing beyond tonight. That was the whole purpose. And again, I think he tweaked his ankle or something like that early in the game. And so trying to be cautious, be careful with both he and AD. That's pretty much it. Just trying to manage those guys. They don't have any active situations going on that we have to, you know, miss a game here, miss a game there, miss a game here, miss a game there. It's not that. It's just, you know, trying to be proactive and protecting them from once the game is out of hand.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.